During what officials consider their most critical snow survey today, the California Department of Water Resources announced this year's statewide snowpack will be close to the biggest they have had on record, and that's going all the way back to 1950.
Fox 40's Zach Boeto has been tracking the snowpack over the last couple of weeks. Joins us now in studio to discuss what this means for the state going forward. Zach?
Nikki, Eric, a lot of snow means a lot of water, and a lot of water means less restrictions and more water for people or local governments who want it. But when the snow melts, we could see flooding. And today's readings will give officials a better idea of what we're dealing with for storage and for spillage.
Joining an elite club for California snow, this year's snowpack will now accompany only three other years which have recorded a snowpack over 200% average, 1952, 1969, and 1983.
Just an incredible situation and a lot of work to do on managing what Mother Nature is giving us.
Hydrographers for the Department of Water Resources took their 20-foot snow tubes out to the department's Phillips Station Monday and recorded a snowpack 221% above average for this time of year.
We recorded a snow depth of 126.5 inches and a snow water content of 54 inches.
The April snow survey is considered the most critical because it's when the snowpack is generally at its peak each year. Plus, they use the snowpack data for snow melt forecasting, or how much water the state will have in the spring and summer when it's most needed.
During those hot, dry summer months, that's when the demand really picks up for the water, and we're lucky enough to have this frozen reservoir in the snowpack eventually melt during those times when we need it the most. So when we don't have the snowpack, that starts to be a lot of trouble for us.
The state, on average, relies on the melted snow for about one-third of its water supply. DWR officials in March said the department will be able to provide 75% of the requested water supplies to its 29 public water agencies throughout the state, a major jump from the 35% the department was expecting back in February because of the increased water supply. But the massive snowpack doesn't come without a downside, and the worry for water officials is flooding, especially in places like the Tulare Lake Basin and the Central, San Joaquin, and Sacramento Valleys.
The staggering amount of snowpack in that part of the state and the very intense runoff conditions that we anticipate are going to create significant challenges with long-duration flooding.
Governor Newsom on Friday signed an executive order to support the Tulare Lake Basin flood response effort, as flooding there is expected to worsen as the snowpack melts in coming months. And while water officials work to manage record snowpack and snowmelt storage, they're also sending out warnings all over the state to be careful around lakes, rivers, and creeks, which are expected to be higher, colder, and moving faster as more water moves through California.
So today we got that snowpack data, and then the snow melt and runoff numbers are expected to be published a week from today. Those numbers will help water and flood managers understand what's coming out of this snowpack. But it is variable because it depends on how hot California gets this summer and how quickly. Nikki, Eric.